I have an orgasmic? I mean, can I have two organic banana bran muffins and a non-fat mocha latte with a sprinkle of cinnamon and a cafe latte to go? I kept Pete up all night. I want to make sure he stays that way.
Maybe you could say that a little louder. The table in the back couldn't hear you.
Oh, make that to go. I don't want to leave him waiting. Oh, my God. I totally forgot about our meeting. I had a crazy, hard, long night last night. You know how that is. Oh, wait, you probably don't.
Well, I was just looking at some flower arrangements, and I flagged a few that I think might work.
Ah, roses. How quaint. Yeah, I was thinking about something a little more upscale. This is kind of too sweet 16. Ah, merci. Try to find something with orchids or irises. They wreak originality, and they're tons more sophisticated than roses. We'll talk about it at my place. I'll text you.
Well, do you have any idea what time? Like, within the hour or later today?
Hopefully after a simply delicious breakfast. You know how long that can take. Toodles.
Tell me I'm not the only one she rubs the wrong way. Well, it sounds like she rubs Pete the right way.
Pete?
But I thought you
no,
two...
No, we're not together. Not anymore.
So you think he and Colby?
Oh, I think it's pretty obvious.
From what I've seen, he's not into Colby Chandler at all.
For emergencies, not some drive-by breakfast.
This is an emergency, Sugar Plum. Days at Cortland, nights at Court Abs. You have got to get some wholesome fuel into you, okay, if you want to keep going. Some real nutrition, not all that liquefied grass business. Now, go put a shirt on so that we can have our coffee together like the old days, okay?
Listen, I have a meeting in like 30 minutes about the Hayward biosensor.
You know, somehow I will never get used to Hayward anything in association with my son or Cortland Electronics.
Okay, it's not Cortland Electronics anymore. Remember?
Well,
Cortec.
As long as you save the company, honey, you can call it Palmer Palooza for all I care, okay? Go get dressed so we can eat.
I love that you want to take care of me. I do. But I can't be your entire universe. You need something or someone of your own.
Petey, I have told you that Sam was my last hurrah. My heart is no longer open for business, okay? I am finished, done, caputo.
Okay, well then, if you don't want to put your heart out there, it's fine. But what about your brain, and your spirit, and that enthusiasm? You know, the same enthusiasm you had about the Chicken Shack or Glamorama.
I did love my Glamorama.
No.
I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Okay, then you know what? Why don't you pick a night this week? We can pound out some ideas while I go take a shower.
It's a deal.
Close Jesse and I are. How do you not tell me that you're investigating him?
That is exactly why I didn't tell you.
He's not working for the Kozlovs. He's a target, just like me.
For your information, you were set up both by Yuri and Jesse.
Jesse was blackmailed. He did what he had to do to get his daughter back.
Maybe he should have come to me.
Maybe he didn't want to plan his daughter's funeral. Do you not remember being at the hospital? Do you not remember that? You saw her lying there, beaten up and broken and raped. Hooked on smack, and this is what you do? You arrest her father?
I had a job to do, and
you know,
I did.
No, you know what you did? You hid behind your badge. And the bottom line is, you didn't tell me the truth.
It's not true.
It is true. And I've been here before. I didn't like it. I don't like it now.
I did it to protect you.
Really? How?
Did you want to interrogate the prisoner before we take him to lockup?
understand if you wanted nothing more to do with me ever again, Zach. And I'm so sorry.
The pariah of Pine Valley.
He doesn't need mommy to pick out his friends.
The technical term for you is not friend.
You just can't stand that Pete denerdified himself while you're trying to make him king of the geeks. Cut the cord, Opal. You're gonna lose Pete forever.
Let's get something straight. I will never lose Pete because Pete loves his mama.
Oh, and his mama loves him a little too much.
Just because, you know, Liza always ran off and left you to fend for yourself every chance she got doesn't mean you need to resent me for being here the way she never was.
I don't resent you. I pity you. Living through your son's success, trying to make yourself relevant while taking care of a grown man who stopped needing mommy years ago.
That's right. Pete doesn't need me anymore, but he likes having me around. And seeing as how he hasn't mentioned you once since you've been back, I highly doubt you could say the same.
Take these off. Do it. Do it!
It's okay, I got this, guys.
Sorry. Super agent over here forgot to tell me that you were arrested.
What I did to you, the things I put you through.
Stop. Okay. I'm gonna get your lawyer. Don't say anything else.
Oh, don't sweat it. I'm covered.
Can I go and talk to my friend in private somewhere?
You can use my office. I'll step out.
Really? You sure it's not wired?
It's not. You can trust me.
I did once, not anymore. Go get it.
Jason?
Oh, thanks.
Oh, my God.
I'm so sorry.
I'll give you a few moments.
You gotta know I never meant to hurt you.
I know that. I do. But baby, why don't you tell me what was going on? I mean, Cassandra's my daughter, you're my husband. Anything that happens to you affects me too. I shouldn't have had to hear this from Joe Martin.
I know,
I should have. I mean, you should have called me as soon as Cosmo contacted me.
I should have told you.
I know, and I was about to before I was arrested.
I'll be back.
Zach, stay, please. You need to hear this. It's time you heard the truth, both of you.
You both deserve that.
You able to get the ticket? Well,
you and Brooke are on a flight to Washington, D.C. tomorrow. The car will pick you up from the airport at 11:30.
Great, great, thanks.
When did my loft turn into Grand Central Station?
Well, she wouldn't go. Well, I'm his mother.
And I'm his...
Yes, his what? His what exactly?
Okay, as flattering as it is to have you two ladies fighting over me...
There's only one lady here as far as I can tell.
Okay, listen, don't you have a Tai Chi class to get to?
Oh, my gosh, you are... How did you know that?
Well, you better be.
No. Would you like me to take out the trash when I go?
Now, that's way out of line.
I'll tell you what's way out of line, Missy.
Okay,
it's the
all
way
right.
You are.
Thank you for breakfast, Mom. Let's touch base later about that whole brainstorming session, huh?
All right.
You're come
a
here.
Good boy. Too good for some people. I'll catch you later.
All right.
Now you're so gonna love what I brought you. What do you say we skip breakfast and go straight to dessert?
Yeah, no can do. I have a meeting at Cortec.
What about friends with benefits?
We'll catch up later.
Thank you. See you later, Pete. Brooke loved throwing in the charity element for the launch party.
Really? What'd she say?
Just that it was a good idea, and the charity should be the Miranda this summer.
Well, that's perfect. You know, I've been doing work over there. That's probably where she thinks I got the idea.
Probably.
And you know, Brooke's been talking on the phone with Bianca about making Dixie the new director. So the gala would be a perfect night to make the announcement.
That would be good press for Chandler Media.
Yeah, and it would amp the donations for the Miranda Center, too.
But if we're gonna really go big, we gotta come up with some kind of auction.
Like a silent auction?
Or not so silent. How about a trip to some exotic place, like Fiji?
Or 1 week on a private yacht?
No, 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 no. No more yachts. Trust me, that's a huge liability. I got it. A guarantee moneymaker. A date with Pine Valley's most eligible bachelor.
I kind of love that. But who would we get to do that?
Dr. Anders? Thanks for meeting me.
Let's try to make this quick. I gotta get back to the hospital.
Simply put,
Cortec wants you to endorse the Haywood biosensor. Not possible. You do realize how important this device is. I mean, among other things, this can prevent millions of deaths of people with heart disease.
Well, yeah, it's a breakthrough device. I mean, it uses stem cells from the body to trick the immune system into thinking that monitor is part of the heart's tissue. I know.
Yeah, so you do know. What's the issue?
Well, Hayward already asked Joe Martin about this, and he told David no.
Yeah, based on a personal issue Joe has with Hayward.
Look, I'm a doctor, not a therapist.
You are a doctor. And you know Hayward. When it comes to medicine, this guy's a genius.
So, am I correct in thinking that you want me to convince Dr. Martin that it's more of a medical breakthrough and he needs to look past the man who invented it?
Exactly. What do you think? You think you can help me?
Look, I'll see what I can do. But the person you should be asking is Dr. Hubbard.
I still don't understand what happened, Jesse.
I was standing in that filthy room where they held Cassandra prisoner. That's when I got the call from Yuri. And Cassandra was right. I did hear her voice.
You heard her voice? And you didn't tell me? Damn it, Jesse, how could you be so cruel? That could have given me hope. I was dying inside. My child was alive, and you kept it from me?
I couldn't risk it. Cassandra was in extreme danger. If I didn't do what Yuri wanted me to do, he was gonna kill her. And my only mission was to bring her home to you safe. So there was no way in hell I was gonna let you lose another child. I had no choice.
What happened then?
Yuri gave me this flash drive that had his dental records on it. He told me where there was a burnt body. Cassandra, for his freedom, that was the deal.
Wasn't that simple, was it?
No. That letter opener was not a part of the agreement. I had no idea those prints would lead back to you, Zach.
Okay.
All you did was help me. And when all the evidence pointed to you, I did nothing.
You did exactly what I would have done to save Spike in the end. Look at me. Look at me. You've been here for me and my family. I'm not gonna turn my back on you now.
Thanks. once Cassandra was home safe, I planned to go after Kozlov and bring him down. But then I was arrested. And Yuri, when he dumped Cassandra's almost lifeless body at home, he was leaving a message. And that message was that he could get to anybody in my family anytime he wanted to.
It's still out there. That he could get to you. To Cassandra. Oh my God, does he know about Lucy?
You will have protection, all of you. I'll take care of it.
If you end up in jail, if you go to prison, he might have someone in the inside who will get to you.
The only thing that is important to me right now is that you understand why I did what I did. I needed to save Cassandra.
So, what do you think of Philip Howe for Talk Temple?
I think he is the most powerful guy in D.C.
And controversial, which makes him a ratings grabber. We're headed to Washington tomorrow to meet him.
What? What do you mean we?
Well, I need your input on this guy, Brooke. You know, whether he's worth our trouble, and the only way to determine that is face to face.
Well, I have this big meeting with Arthur Phillips tomorrow.
And I talked to Artie this morning. He's all in. The funds will arrive by this evening.
Well, that was quick.
Your schedule's clear. They already bought the tickets.
Oh, making it harder for me to refuse, is that correct?
Look, the Hayward numbers were great. We've got to build on that momentum. You want this to be a success, right?
Well, of course. That's why I brought you on board.
Then say yes. Please. Say you'll go.
Didn't expect to see you here.
Hey.
Hey.
Colby's upstairs. She'll be back in a second.
She just left these at my place this morning. When she stopped by for coffee. I couldn't even have it. I had a meeting.
Well, I'm sure she'll want to thank you personally, so let me go get her.
No, don't worry about it. I'm sure she'll be right down.
Okay.
Some catering contracts? A list of DJs with cell phone numbers. Wow, this must have left a pretty good impression with that club in New York, huh? Embracing that inner party girl?
I'm planning a launch party for Chandler Media.
A date with Pine Valley's hottest eligible bachelor. What is Chandler Media into?
It's for the Miranda Center. We're mixing a party with a benefit to show the world that Chandler Media cares.
Okay, first off, everyone knows that Chandler anything only cares about profit. So the benefit part was clearly your idea.
Yeah, well, all we have to do now is find the perfect guy to be auctioned off.
Well, not to toot my own horn, but I've been told I'm not completely unattractive, and I have a sparkling personality, and I know anything technology, and I'm available. Not that I want to be.
What do you mean? What about you and Colby?
I told you before. We're just friends.
That doesn't make any sense.
Celia, don't you get it? Okay, you're the one that I want. The only one.
I know you're pissed that I arrested Justin.
Pissed doesn't even begin to describe it.
I was doing my job.
Your job?
Look, I know that Jesse was in a horrible and just complicated situation, and I tried to give him the benefit of the doubt. I did. Because I know that's what you would have done. But he broke the law. He compromised my case.
You didn't give him the benefit of the doubt. You did your job. You did the opposite of that. You destroyed a very good man. You destroyed his life, you destroyed his family, everything he ever worked for, because you needed a break in a case. Hope the FBI gives you a medal for a job well done.
Oh,
one more thing. I'm glad nothing happened last night. Because I'd hate for you to wake up to think that you did something that wasn't in your job description.
Oh, my God. The lawyer should be here by now, right? Listen, baby, I understand that you're upset because I kept things from you.
I just keep asking myself why. Why you keep doing it? I mean, first, when you were alive all those years when I thought you were dead. Then Ellie, now Cassandra. I mean, what, do you think that I'm that fragile? That I'm not strong enough to handle the truth? Oh, I mean, you did not tell me that my own daughter was kidnapped by sex traffickers. You denied speaking to her when she kept insisting you had. You made Cassandra doubt herself and the rest of us doubt her. And I just want to know why. Why couldn't you just tell me?
You already had so much to deal with, Angela. I could not bear seeing you in any more pain.
Oh, so you thought it would hurt less if you lied to me? Jesse, we both know that the truth always comes out, no matter how well-intended the lie. And it has come out. And now you might go to jail. You want to know what I can't handle? My daughter is going through a living hell. And now she's pregnant. And if that wasn't hard enough, now I get the shock of my life to find out that my husband has been arrested and he might go to prison.
I will deal with whatever happens to me. Right now, you and I, we will help Cassandra through this.
Will we? Or will I be visiting you every third Sunday of the month? We have been here way too many times, Jesse. Way too many times.
On the next All My Children.
Stop it! You're dead!
Get off me. Guess it's time to go meet your lesbo girlfriend.
You might be interested in a little retribution. Maybe stick it to little Petey just a wee bit.
I'm listening. So, Pete told me that you guys are just friends. With benefits.
I love you, Celine Fitzgerald. Only you.